Hello learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. This program is based on Senior Secondary Chemistry course. I'm Dr. Alka Mehrotra and we'll discuss Lesson 5. In our previous program related to Lesson 5, Gaseous and Liquid State, we discussed about Part 1, Types of Intermolecular Interaction Forces. During this part of the program, we will discuss about the various gas laws. The objective of this program is list of characteristic property of gases, state the gas laws, Boyle's law, Charles' law, Gay-Lussac laws and Avogadro's law, and express these mathematically and ideal gas equations. Now, let's discuss about the properties of gases. As you know, gases are highly compressible. I'll show you this with the help of a syringe. Now, if we put it up, you can see this is air. The syringe is filled with air. Now, I'm going to put my finger down. So, I'm closing this very tightly. Now, I'm going to push it down and you can see this is going down slowly, slowly. So, what is happening over here? This is compressing the gas. It means the molecules which were very far apart are coming closer. So, we can say gases are compressible in nature. They exert pressure equally in all directions. And the best example for this is balloon. You must have noticed that in balloon, when you blow the balloon, the air goes equally inside the balloon. So, it means it exerts pressure equally in all the directions. Then, the density of them is much lower than solid and liquid. Now, what about density? What is density? Density is mass per unit volume. Now, we know that volume of gas, we can say, is higher, the mass will be very, very less between them, because if you see in lot of molecule, the volume is more, but the hardly few particles you will find. It means the mass is very less, so the density will also be very less. Then the volume and shape of gases are not fixed. How can we explain this? For this also, we know that the molecules are very far apart. So, when they are very far apart, it's very difficult to bring very close and to give a proper shape. So, we can say the volume and shape of gases are not fixed. Then, they mix evenly and completely in all directions. There also, we have lot of examples where we can say gases are evenly mixed in many directions. There are four measurable quantities of gases. Only four quantities define the state of gas. Number one, the quantity of gas, that is N, which we denote as N, which is a moles, number of moles, the temperature T, the pressure P and the volume V. Now, let's discuss all the laws one by one. Boyle's law. Boyle's law, as you know, it is the effect of pressure on the volume of the gas. Now, Boyle's law was stated by Robert Boyle, that is why the name is Boyle's law. This law states that at constant temperature, the volume of a given amount of a gas is inversely proportional to its pressure. Now, I'm going to show this to you. Boyle's law. Here, we are keeping two constants, that is temperature and number of moles constant. So, what Boyle has done, he kept temperature and number of moles constant and then he checked the ratio or the relation between volume and pressure. And he found that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. So, we can write V is inversely proportional to P, that is V inversely proportional to P. Now, if you cross multiply, we will get PV is equal to, now we are removing the proportionality constant with the equal sign and we are putting a constant. So, we can say product of pressure and volume is constant. We can say that P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Now I want to show you this, how he came to this conclusion. A very simple example, our day-to-day life. Again, we will take a syringe. Let's again assume that here the volume is there. Let's assume that there are 10 molecules are there of air. Now, what are we going to do? We are applying a pressure. Pressure is more and you can see it is going down. So, volume is becoming lesser. So, here this is what Boyle said, that when the pressure is more, volume will become lesser. This is what he explained here, that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. So, pressure is more, volume is less, volume is more, pressure is less. So, if we draw a graph by taking pressure and volume and by keeping temperature constant, this is known as isotherm. So, isotherm is a graph where the temperature is constant. Now, according to Boyle's law, we can say that if we have a perfect gas of a given mass at constant temperature, that is temperature which remains unchanged during the change of state of gas, and if the pressure of the gas increases, then the volume of the gas decreases, and if the pressure decreases, then the volume of the gas increases. So, the conclusion is that the pressure varies inversely to its volume at constant temperature for perfect gas. So, let's discuss about the graph. When the pressure of the gas P is plotted against volume of the gas V, the exponential curve is obtained. However, when the pressure P of the gas is plotted against 1 upon V, a straight line is obtained. If the product of P and V, that is PV, is plotted against pressure, a straight line parallel to x-axis, that is pressure is the x-axis, is obtained. Now we move on to the Charles' law. This is effect of temperature on the volume of gas. This state that at constant pressure, the volume of a given amount of gas is directly proportional to its absolute temperature, that is 273.15 degrees Celsius. This is the theoretically lowest possible temperature. In actual practice, we cannot reduce the temperature of the gas to 0 Kelvin. Now, I'll show you on board how he has arrived on this calculation. Charles' law. He kept the pressure and number of moles constant and he found that volume is directly proportional to T. If we remove this proportionality constant, we get V is equal to KT, where K is a constant. Now, we can say that V1 upon T1 is equal to V2 upon T2. This is T2. Now here, if you have noticed, he said that it is, we have to take the absolute temperature. Charles' law helps us to define absolute temperature also. Now, what is the meaning of absolute temperature? To understand better the absolute zero, now let's draw one graph kind of thing where we have 0 degree Celsius, 1 degree Celsius, 2 degree Celsius and in minus. So, what he said that when we add 273.15 to any given temperature, we get a Kelvin scale. Kelvin or the absolute temperature we get. Now, suppose if 0 degree Celsius and you add 273.15, so what Kelvin you will get? You will get 273.15. Same way, if we add 1 to 273.15, we will get 274.15 and so on. Now, if we move backside, suppose the temperature is minus 1. So, how are we going to do it? Minus 1 plus 273.15, we will get 272.15 and so on like that. So, to get absolute temperature, or in Kelvin scale, we have to add the given temperature with 273.15 and we can get the Kelvin scale. Now, suppose if minus 273.15 temperature is there, so if you add 273 to it, what are we going to get? We get 0. So, 0 here I have mentioned. If we take this in degree Celsius and you add 273.15, we get 0, which is the absolute 0. Now, absolute temperature is the temperature at which the volume of gas is 0. I hope this is clear to you. Now, we move to the Gay-Lussac law. This is effect of temperature on pressure. This law states that pressure of a given amount of a gas at constant volume is directly proportional to its absolute temperature. It means P is directly proportional to T. Now, I'll explain this to you on board. As you know, the volume and number of moles are keeping constant, and the relation between pressure and temperature has been noticed that pressure is directly proportional to T. Now, if we remove this proportionality sign, we will have P is equal to K into T. K is a constant. Now, we can write that P1 upon T1 is equal to K. So, we can also write P1 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon T2, where P is the initial pressure, T1 is the initial temperature, and P2 is the final pressure, and T2 is the final temperature. So, by keeping volume and number of moles constant, we have a relation between pressure and temperature. We can say pressure is directly proportional to temperature, or in other words, temperature is directly proportional to pressure. Now, let's remove this proportionality constant and we have P is equal to KT, where K is a constant. Now, we can also write P1 upon T1 is equal to K, or if we have initial pressure P1 and final pressure P2, initial temperature T1 and final temperature T2, we can have this relation that P1 upon T1 is equal to P2 upon T2. Make a graph of pressure and temperature. Let's take temperature on x-axis and pressure on y-axis. So, the relationship between the pressure and absolute temperature of a given mass of gas at constant volume can be seen over here, that you get a straight line. So, this shows that when pressure increases, temperature also increases. Now, few example, very interesting example you must have noticed in your day-to-day life. Number one is bursting of tire in summer. You must have noticed that lot of tire get burst during the summer. So, what is happening over there? There, we can explain this as a Gay-Lussac law. Like in summers, you know the temperature is very high and the volume is fixed or constant, but the pressure inside the tire gets more because the temperature is directly proportional to pressure. Now, because of the pressure more and it can't expand because volume is fixed, so the tire get burst. Second example, which is very, very common, you must have noticed that people always say, do not take aerosol and do not put fire in front of the aerosol. Now, I'll show you one example. You must have noticed aerosol. Now, this type of bottles you must have noticed, which is known as an aerosol. Aerosol can be where the gases can be compressed in a bottle. Now, whenever you spray it in front of a gas, or if you bring one matchstick near the nozzle of that, what happens over there? If you have noticed, it catches fire. Why? Because what is happening over here, when we are pressing it, pressing means volume is a constant, but the pressure which is there inside it get released. and because of the higher temperature, immediately it catches fire. And the third example, which is again a very interesting example, which is cooking food in pressure cooker. You must have noticed your mama makes food in a pressure cooker and it cooks very faster as compared to when you are making food or when your mama makes food in the open container. So what is happening over there? You know, whenever we are putting anything like dal or rice in the pressure cooker and we are putting water in it and we just seal the cover of that. So what is happening? Here, the volume is fixed. Now, when you are giving temperature to that, because of the seal lid, the pressure becomes very, very high and then you get a whistle kind of thing. So as we are giving more temperature, so pressure becomes more. Because of that pressure, food cooks very, very fast as compared to the open container. Now, the next is Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law is that states equal volume of all gases at the same temperature and pressure contains equal number of molecules. So mathematically, we can say that volume is directly proportional to number of moles. I'll explain this to you on board, but before that, I want to discuss one example. Now that example is blowing of balloon. Now, when we are blowing a balloon, so what happens over there? The volume becomes more. Why? Because the number of moles we are putting inside it. So when you are putting lesser amount of air, so the volume will be less. When you are giving more amount of moles in it, the volume will be more. So we can say the volume is always directly proportional to number of moles. So here in Avogadro's law, pressure and temperature are constant. When pressure and temperature are constant, so what two entities are left? Volume and number of moles. So volume is directly proportional to number of moles. Or if you remove the sign, we have volume is equal to Kn. Again, K is a constant. So if you bring this N over here, we get V upon N is equal to K. Or we can say V1 upon N1 is equal to V2 upon N2, where N is the number of moles. And this is the number of moles, the molecules in 1 mole of gas is 6.022 into 10 power 23. And this is termed as Avogadro constant. So here, if you see 1 mole of any substance contain 6.022 into 10 power 23 number of particles or atoms or molecules, that depends what we have taken. Suppose if we talk about 1 mole of hydrogen, so 1 mole of hydrogen atom contains 6.022 into 10 power 23 number of atoms. But same way, if we talk about 1 molecule of hydrogen atom, so that contains 6.022 into 10 power 23 number of hydrogen molecules. So, at STP, what is STP? Standard temperature and pressure, where temperature we take at absolute, that is 273.15 Kelvin, pressure 1 atmosphere, or we can say 10 to the power 5 Pascal, and volume is 22.4 liter per mole. So the number of moles will remain constant, that is 6.022 into 10 power 23. Boyle's law, Charles' law and Avogadro's law can be combined to give a single equation which represents the relation between the pressure, volume and Kelvin temperature of a given amount of a gas under different conditions. As we know, Boyle's law says that V is directly proportional to 1 upon P. Charles' law says V is directly proportional to T, and according to Avogadro's law, we have V is directly proportional to N. So now, let's combine all these laws. We get V is directly proportional to NT upon P. Or we can say V is equal to nRT upon P. Now R is a gas constant and it is same for all the gases. So here we get an equation that is ideal gas equation, that is PV is equal to nRT. Now let's discuss what we have studied so far. So here we have done that there exists definite relationship between the pressure, volume, temperature and number of moles of gas, and they are given by Boyle's law, Charles' law and Avogadro's law. The gases obeying gas law are known as ideal gases. Dalton's law gives the relationship between the partial pressure exerted by the two reacting gases in the total volume, and Gay-Lussac's law of combining volume and Avogadro's law led to the concept of molecule. Thank you.